I told them I was an art teacher, but in reality, I'm a late lawyer. I went back to school when I was 40 years old. But as far as my teammates, I feel like they don't need to know I'm an attorney. Who wants to give $1 million to an attorney? I've taken on the role of mama. I am Mama J. And I'm kind of leaning into that.
I was like super paranoid the first 2 days.
That's all I was.
Yeah.
Dee is my closest ally. I feel like she's gonna play a loyal game, but I have to have other alliances.
You know what, Drew? You said that you try to work hard to listen to people.
Yeah.
I feel like you do that.
I really try to.
I feel it, though. I feel like you're engaged in that.
I really like Drew. He's my son's age. Drew needs a mom out here. So I need to make him think he can get through another day because I'm here. Lulu gets to send one person from their tribe to either our tribe or Bello's tribe and raid the camp. Caleb comes in peace and, hey, you guys, you know that we have to do this, but he's definitely a player.
So, y'all, he is a sales
player. Yeah, he's a player. He's in sales.
What's his job?
Marketing, but he's in sales.
When it came down to it, the thing he wanted, which was so smart, is information. I don't want Jay suspicious, but right now I've got to get this hammer to Austin, ASAP. Jay is really trying to make a connection with Sean, which worries me a little bit. Why do we care? Why don't we just say Reba Strong and be like, what's up? Glad you're here. But she wants the blindside seafood. And I don't see how I can change Jay's mind.
No, 4 steps.
Down.
You're a lyricist.
At least Sean brings good energy. So I feel like that's good for camp life. How it will transition into challenges, which is the most important, we will see. The challenge today was so physical. If we didn't have Sifu, we'd still be in the water. We would literally still be in a cage in the water, just waving. But the girls, especially Jay, just want to go ahead and get Sifu out now. I hate that attitude. The best way to not go home is to not go to tribal. The best way to not go to tribal is to win a challenge. But I feel like my hands are tied.
I'm doing whatever I want to make sure we're strong.
Yeah,
100%.
Same. Okay.
Because as of now, the best way I don't go home is to keep the numbers. Who knew that Sean's parting words would be like, didn't write your name down? Why is he trying to throw a grenade on us? We were nothing but nice. We were gonna save him. So if Sifu believes Sean, then that means one of us wrote Sifu's name down. We all think Sifu has an idol. So next tribal, we all vote for Sifu, he plays an idol, whoever he names is going home. Yeah, it was bad. The plan was we convinced Sifu that Dee, Sifu, and I are in an alliance and we're all writing Jay's name down. Part of me wants to say, Dee, let's just write Jay's name down and we're safe. The other part of me says, if we really can convince him, we send him home with an idol in his pocket. I don't know what we're gonna do. It should be so simple that Reba has 6, but I think that we're not 6 strong. I think that Jay has been on the bottom and Jay is gonna cut us the minute she can. I feel terrible that 6 are starving and not safe, but being safe tonight is huge. If you do the numbers, the 7 at the feast can decide who goes home. Who's gonna risk throwing out a name? Sifu thinks that Jay wrote his name down, so he's for sure ready to let her go. What he doesn't know is that Dee wrote his name down, but I'm fine with Jay going home tonight because I do feel like she'd cut me if she had the chance. We're all voting Caleb, right? Like, that's all I'm thinking. I'm a little worried because all I'm thinking is I'm not safe. And what if Caleb is going, if I can get Jake and Keturah, maybe I can split the votes, maybe I got something, because Caleb doesn't stop. He is the cat with 9 lives. I'm just hoping he doesn't find his 9th life at my expense. At Tribal Council, I got 2 votes my way. 1 from Caleb, totally expected. 1 from Jake, and not expected.
It was more of a, can I get Caleb to stay, rather than can I get Julie to leave.
Right.
I understand I lied to your face all day.
Did I get that?
You did.
I know. Was that convincing?
Yeah.
Not anymore, though, right?
There's absolutely no way I'm working with Jake going forward. There's no way I can trust him. He lied to my face and I believed him. He's scary to me.
What are we gonna do moving forward? Because it turns out that, yeah, you'll work with me, but only up until it comes against your people.
I think that lines have been drawn. It's kind of feeling like old Bello versus old Reba now. I would love a woman's alliance. But it's gonna be tricky because Dee and I are still four strong with Drew and Austin, who I trust 100%. It's terrifying because we've got the core four, but Jeff keeps splitting us up. So now I'm like, oh my gosh, what if each tribe has to vote somebody out? I'm out. So I go running to Austin. I still don't know what this is, but at least I've got an immunity idol in my bag. But I'm like, what's ahead? I know Kendra wants Dee out. She just wears it. All of her emotion, it's obvious. But I do not want Dee out. I want to go to the end with Dee. I would never write her name. Oh my gosh.
Here's what I would like to also propose.
Okay, yeah.
I would love to write Jake's name again.
Dee thinks Kendra's got to go. But I would like to see Jake go out next. I am fine with the easy votes right now. Plus, wrote my name down. Like, he obviously doesn't want to work with me. If I can believe Bruce and Kendra that we all write Jake, that's music to my ears. That's best case scenario for me. I just don't see it going that easy. At the sanctuary with Kendra and Bruce, we all agreed on Jake. And Dee's like, Kendra's got to go. I'm annoyed because I'm like, okay, I'm working Bruce and Kendra to get Jake out. So it doesn't line with my game.
Yeah.
But what they really want is Jake.
We want Kendra.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't know about Kendra.
So Dee's got her own personal agenda, and I've got mine. And I don't know how that's going to play out yet. I did not sleep last night. I just couldn't sleep. Because I am connecting with people, they're trusting me, and I'm lying to their face.
Ninth person voted out in the second member of our jury, Kelly.
What the hell, guys?
I mean, oh, with both Kelly and Kendra, I was devastated. They just wouldn't even look at me. It felt so personal. The feeling of betrayal is hard for me.
I am used to being very loyal and trustworthy, and you can count on me no matter what.
Just the thought that there are two people out there that are like, man, I wouldn't trust Julie as far as I could throw her, hurts me.
Oh,
sorry.
Julie.
Sorry.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay.
It's just, I don't lie in real life.
I didn't understand how powerful my role that I agreed to, that they put me in as this mama trusting character, would make it hurt that much.
There is a chance at the end here that things could get hairy.
Yep.
You four of you are like people who like, I really, you know, I really care about deeply.
And I'm telling you.
Okay. I just want to know that like, we're all going to be okay. Like we're good no matter what. We're 100%. Good no matter what.
100% okay. Drew.
All right.
We're getting close to the end. And it's even more complex and harder than I thought. It's an emotional mental test for all of us. I mean, I have loved my alliance of four with Drew, Austin, Dee, and myself. But at some point, we gotta turn on each other. I almost can't even go there. How do you vote them out and they love you? I mean, are you kidding me? For Emily to win is one of the greatest moments I think of our season. She did it. She brought herself to the sanctuary.
When I heard that this was going to be an overnight, I already knew I was taking my girls.
Yes!
Yes, 100%.
This is probably the greatest reward. Turns out she picked all the women on the tribe. So the men are back, they're having their boys' night, and we're going to have a girls' night. Just seeing all the letters, it just reminded me I am so rich with an amazing family. On Survivor. If the food is the fuel, the letters are fire. In this game, fire is your life. So these letters, they just reminded me of who I am. And my brother Dan said, at the time of your divorce, with no career, no home, and two small children, you needed a hero, so you became one. I just want you to know that long before that, and to this day, you've always been a hero to me. I want to get Bruce out or Jake out. But Bruce is gonna play his idol tonight. So Jake's the ricochet. I'm still mad he voted for me.
Dude, I'm writing Jake's name down. He's gone. Complete props to Emily. Bruce knew he was getting names thrown his way, and she convinced Bruce that I was playing him, but he's thinking he's gonna blindside me. And goodness gracious, he didn't play his idol. Emily, you're sweet, but that was you, girl.
Yeah, that was.
So her threat level has gone up. It was a genius move. And she came up with the whole plan. On journeys, there's always a chance to get an advantage. And Emily now has a chance to build her resume even bigger.
How you feel about Emily going?
I don't know. She's starting to get some clout.
That would have sat with her at the end, except for now.
No, that's not the play at all.
Boy, I do not want to cut Emily. I think she's smart, but she's making an amazing resume for herself. My gut right now is that all four Reba members want to go Final Four together. But if one of them wants to distinguish themselves and make a big move, it's Drew. He's acting so suspicious. I'm thinking, boy, it's now the time that people are gonna start taking shots. So Drew wins today's challenge and he picks the boys, Jake and Austin. It feels like the right choice. The boys are all starving. And the last reward, Emily took all women. So the boys get to peel off to go do their barbecue. And the girls have a spa day. They're actually gonna try and blindside me. Drew, Austin, my alliance from the beginning, they all wanna vote me out. And I'm mad. I have done nothing but protect you people. And you're turning on me now when we've got easy votes to do? Come on, man up and face me when there's three left. That was the plan. They're not gonna make a move. They're gonna go with the numbers. They don't know that I have an idol. Austin gave me an idol and I'm playing it. So if every single person is writing down my name, whoever I name goes home. She just told me that Austin's her number one. Will she pick him over me? Maybe it's better that I take her number one out. Heading into tribal council tonight, Dee wants me to vote for Emily, but I want to vote for Austin. I hate someone telling me what to do. I've never had my back such against the wall that whichever move I make could either save me or destroy me. Like, it's overwhelming. What a crazy night! They all turned on me, but I played an idol that Austin gave to me. I'm safe. Emily went home. I don't blame you guys. I know you're just playing a game. Dee's the one that told me everybody was gonna blindside me. But we want to keep that cover that Dee and I are working together. So in order to hide that, we're acting totally pissed at each other. But in reality, we still gotta keep that freaking alliance. So that's kind of exciting. What does the Reba Alliance mean now? I just don't know if I could trust the Reba 4 again. I mean, Drew pretty much just blew it up. So it's game on. I did not sleep last night. I just couldn't sleep. Last tribal's vote showed that this is not a kumbaya, let's get to the end with friends. Woo. This is, who do I want to sit with? And I want to take out people that I don't think I can beat at the end.
Do you want to have our talk in a little?
Yes, I do.
Okay, great. Whenever you're ready.
Yeah, I'm ready. I think it'd be smart if the four Rebas were at the end, but I don't know if that's a possible thing. We're like, yeah, we're getting the band back together. But I just feel like it's lies.
The band's getting back together for a reunion tour.
Drew organized this entire blindside against me, and he now says he wants to work with me. I think he's just feeding me what he thinks I want to hear or what I will believe. So at this point, there's only one person that I trust 100%. Dee, can I have a minute of your time? I don't think that people are on to the fact that Dee and I are as close as we are and are working together. But there's six people left, and Dee's the only one that I trust, because she's proved it. She saved my life. So we need numbers. I gotta get Drew out. He wants me out, therefore I have to get him out.
I can't cry out.
What happened to Reba Strong? What happened? We were so good. I'll tell you what happened. Drew happened. Up until now, I've had this great alliance, but my alliance has already taken shots at me, so I can't trust them anymore. So now I got nothing to save me. Unless I can find an idol.
since the entire tribe tried to vote me out. This is my only play. So he's saying the words and I'm just, you're right, you're right, you're right. What he doesn't know is that I'm working with Dee and that she is down for writing Drew's name. But I can't let Jake know that. If it all goes well, there will be actually four names on Drew. We say go, we don't really know where to go. So I just start running and it's far. I do want whatever advantage I can get because I need to win this immunity challenge. So I'm gonna try and keep Keturah and Jay behind me, but I'm already exhausted. I count 17 bamboo and I am first to the lock. But I don't have the right numbers. I would prefer Jake being the next vote. He's been after me for a long time, and Dee has had my back this entire game, and I will have hers.
Okay, well, let's go talk her up about Jake.
Let's just at least try.
And even though I have done a lot of cutting and backstabbing and blindsiding, I need to show some loyalty. And I think the jury will want to see a loyal mom with at least one relationship. When Dee tells me that Jake has an idol, I don't believe it. I mean, there is still a chance that he's just bluffing because that's the only move he's got. And it would help his game if he was able to get me out. So I'm gonna have to do Jake and hope that the idol is fake. My biggest fear was to be the first person voted out. And it turns out I'm the last person voted out. I guess they didn't want to take me to final three, and I'm gonna take that as a compliment. So right now, I'm hoping I made my kids proud.